My next guest is a young man who has been playing the piano since the age of 4. He's a talented songwriter, singer, whose lyrics and music have made him unique in his field. Let's welcome the piano man himself, Billy Joel.
The angry young man with his working class ties and his radical plans. He refuses to bend, he refuses to crawl. He's always at home with his back to the wall. He's proud of his scars and the battles he's lost. And he struggles and bleeds as he hangs on his cross. He likes to be known as the angry young man. Young man with his foot in his mouth and his heart in his hand. He's been stabbed in the back, he's been misunderstood. It's a comfort to know his intentions are good. And he sits in a room with a lock on the door, with his maps and his medals laid out on the floor. And he likes to be known as the angry young man. I believe I've passed the age of consciousness and righteous rage. I found that just surviving was a noble fight. I once believed in causes too. I had my pointless point of view. Life went on no matter who was wrong or right. Oh, but there's always a place for the angry young man, with his fist in the air and his head in the sand. He's never been able to learn from mistakes. He can't understand why his heart always breaks. His honor is pure and his courage is well. He's fair and he's true and he's boring as hell. But go to the grave as an angry. Young man with his working class ties and his radical plans. He refuses to bend, he refuses to crawl. He's always at home with his back to the wall. And he's proud of his scars and the battles he's lost. He struggles and bleeds as he hangs on his cross. He likes to be known as the angry young man. Thank you.
Billy Joel. We'll be right back, right after this.
Billy, I understand this is your very first talk show, is that correct?
Right.
Why is that? Why haven't you been on
a talk show before?
Well, we've done TV shows, but...
But never a talk show?
The sound on a lot of TV shows is shaky. The audio.
And if your record buyers don't hear you the way they hear you on the records, it's not good, right?
Well, we do some power stuff, and sometimes it's just strange. I saw Frampton do your show, and it sounded good, so we
figured... Wasn't he gorgeous?
Yeah. He's good. It sounded good.
Did it sound good? Was the
yes.
audio okay?
It sounded good.
Most sets, you know, just don't have the they're not big enough to put good speakers, you know. It'd have to be as big as this piano if you really want to get good audio from a television
set. It's not easy.
Yes. Did you ever see the equipment that Captain and Tennille carry around?
Oh, yes.
Oh, it's nine vans.
You've had a lot of classical training. It's very obvious watching you.
I started when I was a little kid.
How did your parents react? You have quite an investment in you at that point, you know, and suddenly you start playing contemporary music, and they probably wanted to see you on a concert stage.
They just want me to be happy. You know, my father plays the piano. He can really. I don't play in front of my father. He's a classically trained pianist from the Prussian school. Don't play the wrong note. You know? So I don't play in front of him. My mother's just be happy.
That's good. Show them your finger. This has to happen to a pianist, right? He gets a little. You did that on a. You were telling me a bad piano.
Well, last night I was jamming down at the Main Point. It was like 3 o'clock in the morning. That we got into this old rock and roll 12-bar blues boogie. And when you do this kind of run on a piano, you're supposed to wet your finger. You're supposed to. I didn't wet my finger, and it was a bad piano. I just ripped it off. And
oh, swell.
Doing a Mike Douglas show tomorrow.
your first hit, Piano Man, was taken, I'm told, from a real life experience of yours. What was it?
It was working in a piano bar in Los Angeles. I was running away from a record company at the time.
What do you mean by that? I understand.
Well,
trying to break a contract with them?
Yeah, they kind of own this. They own this. They still have a little bit of this. But I was just like, hey, you know, I gotta get away from these people.
Why did they have you recording the wrong material, doing things against your will?
They were just signing away. They were just having me sign everything away, and I didn't realize it until I was, you know, into a career that wait a minute, I gave everything away, and they were just. You know, going out there, kid, get him, kid.
Yeah.
Hey, make that money. And I was going, what money?
You hadn't seen any of it. Play just a little bit of Piano Man for me.
I started at 9 o'clock on a Saturday and the regular crowd shuffled in. I mean, the whole thing went down in that song. While I was doing the gig, I said, I gotta get a song that.
Your next number is from your new album, Turnstiles. Which one is it?
New York State of Mind. It's for New York City. New York gets dumped on a lot, so I'm thinking it needs.
That's right. Not too many people say nice things about New York. It's the most exciting city in the world. I mean,
well,
it's electric.
I just tell people, you know, sometimes when we announce a song, we say, you know, we're going to do a song about New York, and you hit boo or yay. I tell people, look. You may not like New York, but you got to understand, if New York goes down the tubes, all those New Yorkers are going to move out there.
do a little New York State of Mind. You know, before you do, this morning, when we were rehearsing, I had a feeling when you walked over and checked out that stage, that's what you'd really like to do, what Dandy does, to stand up in one thing.
I do that during a show.
Do you?
I mean, I stand up and talk. I don't just sit up there and ignore the audience. I like to
That's great.
Get down and fool around.
Okay. We can do a little New York State of Mind. Here is Billy Joel. Okay?
Thank you.
folks like to get away, take a holiday from the neighborhood, have a flight to Miami Beach or to Hollywood. I'm taking a Greyhound on the Hudson River line, 'cause I'm in a New York state of mind. Stars in their fancy cars and their limousines, been high in the Rockies under the evergreens, but I know what I'm needing. Yeah, I don't want to waste more time. I'm in a New York state of mind. Was so easy living day by day, out of touch with the rhythm and blues. But now I need a little give and take. The New York Times, Daily News. To reality, and it's fine with me, 'cause I've let it slide. I don't care if it's Chinatown or on Riverside. Oh, I don't have any reasons, I left them all behind. I'm in a New York state of mind. I'm in a said I'm in a New York state of mind.
Billy Joel.
Here now with another of his great hits, the entertainer, Billy Joel.
I won't be here in another year. I don't stay on the job. Oh. I'm the entertainer, and I'm glad to pay my price. Things I did not know at first, I learned by doing twice. Oh, but still they come to haunt me, still they want their say. So I've learned to dance with a hand in my pants. I let them rub my neck and I write them a check, and they go their merry way. Oh. Faces. I don't remember names, oh, but what the hell, you know, it's just as well. It's after a while and a thousand miles, it all becomes the same. I am the entertainer, I bring to you my songs. I like to spend a day or two, but I can't stay that long. No, I got to meet expenses, I gotta stay in line. I gotta get those fees to the agencies, and I'd love to stay, but there's bills to pay. So I just don't have the time. I am the entertainer, I come to do my show. You heard my latest record, it's been on the radio. Oh, it took me years to write it, they were the best years of my life. It was a beautiful song, but it ran too long. If you're gonna have a hit, you gotta make it fit. So they cut it out of 305. I am the entertainer, the idol of my age. I make all kinds of money when I go on the stage. Oh, you see me in the papers, I've been in the magazines. But if I go cold, I won't get sold. I get put in the back in the discount rack like another pan of beans. I am the entertainer, and I know just where I stand. Another serenader, and another long-haired man. Today I am your champion, I may you win your hearts. But I know the game, and you forget my name. I won't be here in another year. I'll stay on the charts.